Okay, here we have what is truly a Japanese maritime self-defense force carrier strike group with two carriers. When the Japanese produced the Hyuga class, which are two smaller versions of these carriers you see here, which are the Izumo class, I predicted that if they built any more, they would probably put F-35Bs on them. I got a lot of criticism for that because the Japanese Constitution calls for no offensive weapon, and they had acts of their diet that called for no aircraft carriers. However, with the buildup of the Chinese aircraft carriers in the Western Pacific, clearly the Japanese were concerned, as is all of the countries in the Western Pacific, because it's leading to a naval arms race. Well, lo and behold, they built the Izumo class, which are 30,000 ton carriers, and they then just recently announced that they would be buying between 40 and 60 J-35B aircraft, F-35B aircraft, which are the Joint Strike Fighter from the United States that are capable of vertical takeoff and landing, or short takeoff and landing. The United States is buying hundreds of those planes for its 10 large flat deck assault ships, which are about the same size as these ships. Actually, they're a little bigger. They displace 45,000 tons and are a little longer. So now we have the true coming forth of a Japanese carrier strike group. And what I have here is the Japanese carrier Kaga, which is the second of the two. And I have, though they can probably carry up to 24 joint strike fighters, I have each one of them outfitted with 14 on deck. This is the Kaga. It is the only one that is a full deck version. I had hesitated building these because they're 1/700 scale. But as you may be able to see, I went all out and bought the photo etch aftermarket upgrade kits for these ships. So they actually have railing and instrumentation. The Japanese are building jump or ski jumps for these carriers. The new Izumo is already out with a jump kit. And that's the other one. The 83 is the Japanese Izumo for which the class is named. As you can tell, it too has the aftermarket kit placed on it. And you have jets there preparing to take off. As well as, I might add, on both of them, I added a EV-22 Opsrey, which had been proposed for the British carriers. They ultimately turned that down and went with a helicopter. But as you can see, the triangular-based radar on top, I went with that design because I believe the Japanese ultimately will want that design. It's pressurized, it'll fly higher, it'll see much further, and it seems ridiculous to me when a design is available not to use it that would protect these carriers even better. But the Japanese are very capable of providing an escort flotilla for these aircraft carriers. Out in front here, you see the a Hsirane submarine. It's a air-independent propulsion submarine. It's got a range of 7,000 miles, very long range. It's capable of up to 23 to 25 knots underwater. So it could keep up with these carriers if they wanted it to. I also have their best vessels. Over there you see the Aegis class vessel Atego, which is a class of four ships, and they've just built two advanced versions, so they have six of those. And then back here or on the right, you have a Congo class vessel, DDG-174, the Kashimira, and they have four of those. So the Japanese will have 10 absolute Congo and Atego class vessels, which are loosely based on the Arleigh Burke and the Arleigh Burke 2A. The Japanese have also built this vessel. They now have six of them, the latest two being a follow-on version of the first four, the Akizuki. And they are very powerful with dual band radars, APARs, and a 32 cell MK-141 launcher that carries four ESSM missiles in each, so up to 128 missiles. That provides between the two and three ships, and back there towards the back you have a Takanami class, which was the forerunner of the Akizuki, which also has a 32 cell launcher carrying ESSM missiles. So you have very strong everywhere from close-in weapon system all the way out to long range, because the Atego and the Congo can carry all of the SM missiles, including those missiles that can reach up into the atmosphere and knock down ballistic missiles. The Soryu is a great submarine. It was offered to the Australians. They ended up taking a German vessel and immediately found out within months that the plans had been stolen by the Russians. So they're not happy about that. Also, I wanted to add, I added the Mashu replenishment class vessel. This is a very, very detailed 1/700th scale ship with a neat aftermarket detailing package. So it's got great railing, and as you can see, it also has in its loading davits there the hose work for doing the replenishment across to ships that would pull up to the side and fill up on fuel and other replenishment. It's also very capable of vert rep. It's got a large enough hangar back here. I've got an EH-101 helicopter and an Osprey that the Japanese are buying and using on their larger ships. And it's got a very, very great detail on this ship. You might be able to see the ladders and railing back there, and the railing up on the mast. So Japanese have come up with a very effective carrier strike group. Going forward, if they were to go out to sea with 48 F-35B strike fighters, that would be a strong, strong capability. And it's one I'm sure that the Chinese are worried about. The Koreans have announced that their Dokdo class, which is similar to this, a little shorter, a little smaller, will also be carrying F-35Bs. We know the Australians are capable of it, and there's been talk about it with their Canberra class. Those two ships, the two Dokdo ships, and these two mean six ships in the Western Pacific capable of providing defense and an answer to the Chinese carriers. Now, the Chinese carriers are much bigger. They're 50,000 tons. They carry 50 aircraft, but right now those aircraft are principally J-15, good aircraft, very capable. Improvements on the Su-33 that the Russians had, but they're still behind the strike stealth fighters that the United States is providing these countries. And then, of course, the United States has the F-35B capable of 22 of those aircraft on 10 of their amphibious assault ships. In fact, have tested them as escort carriers with purely a loadout of helicopters for SAR and ASW, and 20 Harriers or F-35Bs for aircraft. Back here, again, you've got, like I said, the Takanami. The Takanami is a very powerful, very capable ship, similar to the Akizuki, which we see over there, but not as strong in terms of electronics and in terms of battle management. However, they do have four or five of these ships, which are upgrades to the Murasami class, which they have 13 of. So the Japanese have, you know, upwards of 50 destroyers that they can escort their carriers with, and they've proven that they can build these carriers rather rapidly. In fact, there is a new design that has been talked about that is just a little bigger and would carry up to 30 F-35Bs that the Japanese could build about as quickly as they built these two. They built these two ships. Each one took about 2 years to build and another year to commission. The Chinese are taking 4 years to build their big carriers and commissioning them in a year or two. So the answer to the Chinese buildup is being formulated before our eyes, with, of course, the United States with its 10 nuclear carriers that also carry the F-35C, which has a larger wing, meaning more fuel, meaning longer range, and more weaponry. So they intend to start with 10 of those in a squadron for each carrier, and ultimately there will be more. There will probably ultimately be two squadrons of those as they shift over later, probably in the late 20s and the early 30s, and begin introducing the sixth generation fighters, which will be either Grumman and or Boeing's sixth generation fighter. If you want to see a copy of how that will look, look up my video on the 1/350th scale USS Enterprise CVN-80, which will be the third Ford-class ship. I built that with a 2030s Air Wing in mind, where the oldest jet on the ship is the F-35C, and then the Boeing and the Grumman 6th generation fighters are on there, and it's pretty awesome. The Otego and the new Otego in particular are very powerful ships with 96 vertical launch cells, as are the Congos. They're a little older. The Otego have the deck and the hangar like the Burke 2A, and they displace over 10,000 tons, particularly the newest class, and are outfitted for command capabilities for defense of a task force. So there you have it. The Japanese Maritime Self-Defense Force Kaga with F-35Bs filling the deck and its ski jump wrap, and the carrier Izumo. I'm changing, just for my own purposes, the designation from DDH to CVH for these carriers. Originally, they were built as helicopter-carrying destroyers, and that was to replace the Hsirane and the... what was the name of the other one? The Hsirane and the Hurane, which were, in fact, helicopter carrying destroyers, 7,500 tons, big large hangar carrying three helicopters. and fulfilling the role of the Japanese for us in anti-submarine warfare. The Hyuga looks like these ships, but smaller, 640 feet. But there's no question that they're flat-top carriers, and themselves could probably carry F-35s. But I doubt they will. I think they are the true replacements for the Hsirane and Hurane, and they will be used as very strong task force leaders for anti-submarine warfare. These two ships, longer, many more aircraft, in my mind, from the beginning, were built to be able to carry the F-35s as an answer to China, if China continued building their ships, their aircraft carriers, and they did, and so the Japanese have. And implicit in announcing the F-35B for these two ships is the announcement, but unsaid, that the Japanese could build more if they felt the need. So hopefully this will be the answer to that, and the arms race can slow down or stop, because I don't think Japan can keep up with Korea. Excuse me, I don't think China can keep up with Korea, Japan, Australia, the United States, and you probably ultimately would have India in that mix too. They have expressed interest in the F-35 for the three carriers that they are building. So there you have it. I'm also very happy to have the replenishment ship. It's a nice ship. It was the largest ship the Japanese Navy or Japanese Maritime Self-Defense Force had ever built, 25,000 tons and well over 700 and something feet long before they built the Izumo class. The Japanese have five replenishment ships like that, two of the Mashu class, and then three of the almost as big preceding class. So once more, even though it's a 1/700 scale representation, this is the true Japanese carrier strike force with two carriers. Thanks for watching. Be sure to check out all my videos on particularly 1/350th scale naval models, 1/72nd scale aircraft models, and now 1/700th scale models, although I dearly hope that they build a 1/350th scale model of either of those, because if they do, I'll buy two and build both and then have the 1/350th scale version of the same. This is Jeff Head. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.